Ah, the sun is shining. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this. This is going to be a very, very special vid, I think, for numerous reasons. The first is, today I'm going to do a road that I've wanted to do for this series since I started this series. It's the first of the actual famous roads, if you want to call it that. We're going to do the Snake Pass today, which is going to be fun times for all. But more importantly than that, I don't know if you can tell by just looking at your screen, look to the right, to the front, to the left, we are surrounded by MGFs and TFs. And this is going to be a lot of fun, in my opinion. We're going to do Snake Pass. We're doing the thing today called the Topless Run. You couldn't have asked for better weather today. This is perfection weather-wise. And we're raising money today for Dementia UK and for Balkan Underdogs, who are two great charities, and everyone has paid a little donation to come and do this run, and we've all got our cars all cleaned up nice, and yeah, today's going to be special. Just thought I'd go through, if I may, since the last video I filmed was in early August. Since then, Meg has had so many changes done to her. You wouldn't believe how much work has been done to this guy. Where's that guy going? He's bailing on us already. So, going through them, as you can see on your screen, you can see, if you need to even look at it, there's a new MG badge there, the blue one. More important than that, wow, did you hear that? If I do this, probably hear my new exhaust. Yeah, the exhaust I talked about all that time. I've got the TT Mark 7 exhaust bomb. And I've also got these new wheels on. They're not new, they are refurbished, and they're a bit tatty in places, but I've added the blue rim blades that you can see to cover up the scuff marks on them. And yeah, she's starting to get there now, Meg is. I'm starting to get very, very, very pleased with her. You know, and now we're sat here just chilling, waiting. We're going across the Snake Pass. We're going all the way over to Ashbourne eventually. It's going to be a long ass drive, but it's going to be a lot of fun. And we're heading, if I remember rightly, we're heading to a place, I think it's called Coniston Water. It's a reservoir that's about 30 miles away from here. So you're probably looking at a good couple of hours. And of course, because we're going in convoy, this one's going to take a while. So join me, ladies and gentlemen, as we go across the Snake Pass. Interesting. I've never driven the Snake Pass the way we're going, though. I always come from Sheffield to Glossop, but that makes it more fun, doesn't it? You know, the first bit that's going to be interesting is this bit here, because when we pulled into MGF and TF bits earlier on, the traffic getting into here was ridiculous. So it's going to be a laugh watching us all get out of here. You know. Okay, so I stopped recording because we were just going through Glossop and it was taking forever. So here we go then. Out of Glossop, into the hills, into the countryside, in a line full of MGs with a whole raft of people looking at this stream of cars going, the fuck? Here's an interesting one point, interesting fact. I bought Meg from a woman who lived in Glossop, or lives in Glossop. Interesting little fact. So she's technically back home. What's great here is that we have got a line of cars, right? Because going through the middle of Glossop, like all those cars that weren't MGs were pulling in, but now they've all of them have filled out. So it's just a row of MGs. It's wonderful. Here we go. Love it. I've been looking forward to doing this run. I keep doing drives and going, oh, this is making a great drive. Let's record that for the series. So I've been trying to sort of avoid putting on the... God, it's a TF there. I see it every time I come up this road. And it's never moved. I've always wanted to show you the Snake Pass and the Woodhead Pass and things like that. But yeah, there's always been on the road, so... There you go, this is where it starts. There's a lovely local. climb a lot. First 5 miles maybe of this run are just climbing, climbing, climbing. Interestingly, by the time we get there, if, unless I'm much mistaken, right, my, right now Meg's on 72,954 miles. So the run's about 40 miles long, so she might click, just click on to 73,000 miles. 12,000 miles in the years that I've got home now. It's remarkable when you think about it, isn't it? Here's a question now. Do I just drop back a little bit so I can probably fall down? Look at this. Marco. Oh my god, I wish you could see what I can see in the mirror. There's just a row of empty. yesterday, and the guy who put them on for me, Lee, lovely, lovely man. You know, really probably warm and open and honest, and realising he's got a gorgeous TF. Absolutely stunning car. Really nice guy. He did those for me. Remember the last episode I did, episode 3, we're actually going to go down the road that I did that one, but the other way, we're not part of this drive, so good. So I've got the heater pointing, yeah, I'll do that, see that, pretty exclusively out there. Oh, we've got cars in the limited, I've got half, at least 4 or 5 got through the lights, you know. Thank you to everyone who's watching these events. If you, you know, they're made for me, and there's a select, a small group of people who like them. I'm not expecting anyone to actually watch them. So if you do and you're liking them, fantastic, that's really good. I've done loads of them, got the exhaust, got the wheels, got my stickers done, I've got my chrome on the inside, it's all you, and then as soon as you do something, you're like, oh, I can think of at least 20 things I want to do now. And this old couple on the right hand side here, can you see him? Probably can't see him where you are. MGs! Give him a wave. Oh, yeah, give me a nod. Didn't wave, we nodded, and I wiped my head myself in the head. The girl in front of us taking the photos, which is quite fine. Why are you taking any photos of from behind? I mean, look, you're on the hill now.
Goddamn siege.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 MGs, and then there's 3 cars that are MGs. How dare you? The best part so far, well not the best part, but yeah, what a good thing, is we pulled into this village and there was a guy and he just couldn't believe how many MGs there were. So he's like, one, you know, he's seen counting one, two, because I think I'm like the 7th or 8th TF as it goes past. I just leaned out the window, I was like, there's about 50 of us all told. Just, the look on her face was absolutely incredible. Absolute picture.
I sit by the window and I run like a bastard.
Well, that's my nice thing for the day, don't you? Guy pull out, but now I've heard we've lost the train, and I don't actually know exactly where I'm going, so let's go play Operation Catch-up, shall we? The other thing, oh no, what if these people behind me, what if they're following me? Oh god. turn right onto the A6. And then, remember, as I was saying before, you know the road that I did in the last episode of the Marc and Megs Adventures? The road between Ashbourne and Bakewell. Yeah, we're going to go back down that road later on, but we're all the way. straight on the crossroads, that says to me. Again, just like it was in the first episode. This is better. This is what I love about this. Look at this. This is a genuine smile. Follow the other MG. everyone's checking where the fuck we're going. Is the truth.
I think we're all very lost.
Get in or out of the cafe as well.
It's a goddamn siege.
Hey, Mac. Hey, Mac. Right. I think I know where we're going. Actually, that's a massive lie. I've no idea where we're going. Nah, I've got a rough idea now. We all got thrown at that, yeah, you know, where the three-way traffic lights were. Should have gone left, like I thought. Like I originally thought. Don't mind. I'm gonna follow this guy. We'll get there eventually. Isn't it an interesting one, right? Okay, isn't it genuinely interesting one, right? I drove this road about 2 weeks ago in the works van and thought to myself, I would love to take Meg over that. Genuinely would. This takes you down to Cromford and it's really, really windy, really, really nice, like the back way over, instead of going up the A6. So, this is working out great. It doesn't matter the fact we couldn't record over the snake if this is the way it's going to turn out, does it? right place. It means I won't remember when we parked on our own or with the other non-MGs. Can you see in front? Remember before I mentioned about the roll hoops? The car in front. Look at those. With the wind deflector. That's what I want. Thank you. are back on track.